bootloaders. Did you know that all MikroTik devices with RouterOS have two types of bootloaders on board? During device startup, something needs to load the operating system, and if it fails, having a backup becomes essential. The primary bootloader utilized during normal boot operations has several settings, and it can be upgraded to match the RouterOS version. You can also downgrade, but not lower than the factory default version, which is the minimal system version of the device. Router boot upgrades usually include minor improvements to overall router boot operation. It is recommended to keep this version upgraded. If you see that upgrade firmware value is greater than the current firmware, you simply need to perform an upgrade. To perform an upgrade, go to System, Router Boot menu and press Upgrade. Or use CLI command System Router Boot Upgrade followed by Y. You can manually perform upgrades every time or preferably turn the auto upgrade. Navigate to Settings subsection. The first option is what you are looking for, but there are other available options worth noting. Boot device can help you to trigger net install or flash fix. CPU frequency enables performance reduction in overheating scenarios. Boot protocol could help you with IP address occlusion during net install. Silent boot mode can be useful for devices equipped with a beeper. Advanced devices offer additional settings such as baud rate for serial console, boot delay, enter on setup and more. Detailed descriptions of these settings can be found in our manual. In the event of boot-related issue, the force backup booter option becomes essential. When you can't even start the device, it won't be accessible. However, you have options during the initial boot-up process. The typical go-to way to initiate the backup bootloader is hold the reset button during boot-up. First, power off the device, then start holding the reset button and power on the device. After about 1-2 seconds from initiate the boot, release the button. RouterOS startup should be then initiated by the backup booter. If that helps you boot up, ensure to upgrade the primary bootloader to resolve the issue. If the reset button is damaged or inaccessible, you could change the bootloader settings through serial console. For example, during boot up, press Del to enter the boot menu. Press B, booter options, select the force backup booter loading. Then press X, the device will reboot using the backup booter. Remember to set it back to the regular booter when finished. You can do it after the boot up from RouterOS. That was a brief overview of regular and backup bootloaders in MikroTik devices. They are there to ensure your network keeps running even when something goes very wrong, though most likely you'll never need to worry about them. Thanks for watching and see you next time.